So this little guy is the Opus from Two-Notes. It's basically a preamp sim, it's a power amp sim, it hosts IRs, theirs and yours. You've got onboard EQ, you've got onboard enhancement, you've got onboard reverb. It's not much bigger than the size of a standard kind of overdrive pedal, as you can see on your screen. It's quite small. For that reason, it fits beautifully either on the desktop as a recording device, as a tone generator really, or on your pedal board, perhaps at the end of the signal chain with which to, you know, you can feed your pedals into it and you've basically got an amp sim with any amount of IRs and reverb at the end of it. If we have a look at the inputs and outputs, we'll start on the left-hand side. You've got a MIDI input, so you can control the presets with MIDI. You've got an auxiliary input. You've got a headphone output. You've got a balanced XLR DI out, which is what we're hearing right now. You've also got a line out, and the line out's going to be useful. A quarter-inch line out will be useful for popping on your pedal board. Perhaps you might want to whack a delay or a chorus or a reverb or all of that after it. On the right hand side, you will find a multi-selectable input. Now you can either choose to use your amps speaker output via a load box, absolutely essential, into this guy, which means that you can use your amps preamp and run the power amp sims or the reverbs, the cabinet IRs, all that sort of stuff. So you can actually use it as kind of a post amp effects processor if you wish, or you can just use the standard instrument input, or you can use a line input. So it's very versatile. Next to it, of course, is the USB-C, which is what we're interfaced with on my Macintosh computer today to look at the Torpedo Remote software, which will either run on iOS or Android. If you want to run it Bluetooth wirelessly from your phone, it works perfectly, and you just download it from the App Store, and it will find the Opus fairly quickly, and you can get started, you know, inside 2 or 3 minutes. Or you can use the same interface on your Mac or Windows machine. Today I'm using it on the Mac. You are looking at the Torpedo Remote interface on your Mac. Now, everything I can do on this beautiful looking interface, and I have to say that it is, it's quite a gorgeous piece of graphics, you can do also in here with the two little remote and press controls, knob controls over here. So you can either have it in perform mode, which it's in at the moment, so I can just select through the presets like so. As soon as I press this guy, I'm into the hierarchical menu, and then I can go and select all sorts of different things, much the same way that you can do it on the remote. And one more press and I'm back into perform mode. So in an editing situation, I would probably either use my phone or I would use the desktop app, which is what we're going to do today. Okay, so this is a little Charvel Pro mod from 2016. I've just dialed up a random preset then while I was demonstrating, but it gives me a good excuse to show you what is going on here. Let's dial up a preset. Here we go, drop me. All right, so if we have a close look at this interface, first of all, I can hear that it's a bit noisy. Down here in the bottom left, we've got a gate, a noise gate, and it's actually got a learn control, which is very handy, especially in high gain situations like this. So you hit the learn and it says mute your strings. Okay, I'm muting the strings. That's not bad. I'm going to do it again. Great. No, I've already learned. Stop learning. Next, it is the preamp, and you can select from 5 different types of amplifier, generic amplifiers. So if I go to Foundry, it's basically going to be a Fender amp. Now that threshold is much too high, I'm going to turn the gate off. Great. So 5 different preamps, Foundry, Foxy, which is going to be a Vox sort of a thing. Albion, which will be a Marshall. Nifty 50, which will be a 5150. Now I haven't adjusted any of the tone controls to suit these. And then you've got a Peggy bass amp as well for the bass players, which is a cool feature. I'm going to go back to, say, the Albion, which is the standard old Plexi Marshall. Then over to its right, you can choose what sort of power amp configuration you wish for. Switch it on, pull down the menu. You can see, oh, okay, let's go for a push-pull EL84. Contour control. And you can decide between pentode and triode. Over here we've got choice of two microphones. Now I can either use my mouse to move them about and select which type of microphone I want. For instance, a 57. Place it behind the cab or in front of the cab. Move the axis like so and the distance. And then I've got a choice of a second microphone as well. So for instance, I might want a 421. Turn it up over here a little bit. Then we go to the top right, and this is where our cabinet selection happens. And you can see these little purple buttons up here. If I've got torpedo checked, it will allow me to choose between one of the 32 cabs that the Opus actually ships with. You've got 1x12s, you've got a bunch of 2x12s, you've got a bunch of 4x12s, which are just off your screen, unfortunately, at the moment. But I'm going to choose the Friedman 412. Beneath it, you've got an EQ section. So if I want to get rid of some of that mid-range, perhaps. Actually, I'm going to move that mic to the front. Better. That's better, and turn him down. Then we've got the enhancer, which you can turn on or off. And then below it, you've got reverbs. And in reverb world, we've got a choice of about 10 different reverbs. So if I want to choose, say, a plate reverb, I get a nice graphic of the plate. Turn it up here. And then I can adjust the color and the echo and the size of the plate, as well as the mix. Up here in the hierarchical menu, we've got IR loader, so we can choose to select, you know, any one of a million zillion IRs that I have on my computer, or the Torpedo's own IRs. And then we've got cabinet manager, same sort of thing again, just to sort out all of your different IRs. Then preset manager, if you've got a heap of different presets for different two notes things, they're going to appear in here, as well as the factory presets, which are over here on the right. And then another IR manager, if you've got IRs stored on your computer somewhere, you can access them from there. But really, it's all about the sounds. Let's have a listen to some of these factory sounds right now. Sultans, which is probably going to be something to do with the clean tones. Not too bad at all. I might like to choose a different cabinet though. I might like to choose a Silver Jensen cabinet. Like to wetten it up a little bit. And our little Opus, you can see that it's giving us a bit of a readout there to tell us how we're going as far as the input and the output levels go. That's handy. What we got here? I'll just do a couple of them because I could be here all day otherwise. Shred's not dead. That sounds like fun. Great. Atomic Punky. Bit loud. I'll turn him down. Bit noisy with this guitar too, so in goes the gate. And I can choose hard gate, which will really shut it up. Turn it down a bit. great. So if I chose a different cab for Mr. Atomic Punky, what did they call it? Atomic Punky. NOSV30. You can see that the cabinet choice is going to make all the difference. That's great. So if you had a MIDI controller, you could use it to select those different presets, stick it at the end of your pedal board, put a tube screamer or whatever in front of it, and then if you wanted to, you could use the line out on the Opus to feed delays and reverbs and that sort of stuff. It's an extraordinarily useful device because as sitting on my desktop, quite happily taking up very little footprint, but it will be equally at home on a pedal board. And there are a ton of sounds. There are 32 cabs, all of the microphones, the reverbs, you know, the different ways of shaping the tone that come with it. But you can also access their online store, and there are hundreds more IRs, or you can buy them from third parties. The Opus from Two Notes, very useful little device. See you soon.